Hello everyone, Pedro here with GetResponse. In this video, I want to show you how you can change your website settings. I'll be assuming you already have a website, and if you don't, make sure that you check our tutorials on how you can create a website. Right now, I'm just in the website builder page, so I went to menu on top left and clicked website builder. To access the website settings, there are two options. You can either go to the right and click edit site settings, or you can just click on your website here. And you'll be taken to the statistics page, and here on the right you just click edit settings. The first setting here is the name of your website. This name is just for you, no one else will see it. It's used to identify the website for you. I will call mine language school, and when I click out you'll see that it will save automatically. There will be a notification here on the top right regarding the changes, right? Changes saved, as you can see here. And then you can click publish site. Now this means to make the website available for the public. Right now this is taking me to the same page as when you click to connect your own domain. And as you can see, website name, this is just the one we changed. And next you have free GetResponse domain. This is actually a subdomain that GetResponse provides you for free. And I want my website to have the URL languageschool.grwebsite.com. This is the subdomain that we provide. And then you can click publish. I will show you in a second how it looks like. And if you have a custom domain already, you can connect through here. We have a whole FAQ article about it. And you can also purchase a domain with us. There's just something to consider. You can only purchase a domain with us if your payment method is currently with your credit card. Otherwise, you will see it just as in here. Like me, I don't have a credit card assigned, so it is grayed out. We also have an FAQ about it. Make sure that you go through it if you are thinking about purchasing a domain. Right now, I'll just click to publish so that you can see the URL and that you can click to access the website. This is basically, this will take us to the page that I went through before, which includes the statistics and everything else regarding the website. As you can see, active here, languageschool.grwebsite.com. This is what I wanted to show you. Let's go back to the statistics here and domain, connect domain. This will be the page we went through when we clicked publish site. Favicon. A favicon is the icon that appears in the tab at the top next to your website. So here we have a GetResponse icon. To upload your own, just go here, upload favicon, and then you'll see that next to your website you'll have your own icon. Next you have cookie consent banner. So this is where you inform customers that you are collecting data from them, and they can either accept or decline it, or in a third option is that you actually disable it. You can disable it here, you can edit the notification, you can edit the title, message, decline button text, and confirmation button text. I will actually change to accept here so that you can see. Now it changed to accept. Next we have analytics and integrations. You can turn on analytics and remarketing. This means that you can integrate GetResponse with different platforms that can gather statistics for you. So one example is Google Analytics. You can see more here on how you can integrate. You can add multiple platforms at the same time, Google Tag Manager, Facebook Pixel, for example. All of them at the same time can be connected. Make sure that you check our FAQs on how you can do it. They are step by step. You just click here on the links and you'll be able to do it as well. Next we have GetResponse chats. So a chat is always something that you want to have. This will be an icon in your website that will allow the visitors to click and chat directly with you. This is a very useful option. Make sure to have it active. If you want to have a chat, you can also just disable it, of course, and it will not show. Next you have disable analytics cookies. If you actually enable this option, it will it will mean that we will be collecting less statistics for your website. So this is actually preventing us from gathering specific statistics. So in case you want everything from your website, every statistic, make sure to keep it as it is here. And lastly, we have business information. This information is taken from your account. So if you go to your profile, manage account, you will be able to edit the default that's shown here. And for this website, you can just click update information and you will see that you can change all of them here. So it's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be coming with more tutorials for you. And for now, that's it. I wish you a great day and stay tuned for more.